We're here to help you.
You need us.
So worried.
Silence is lonely.
We didn't know where you'd come.
We're here to help.
Into the mountain.
Can you see it?
Shall we tell her where to go?
It's not far. Go on.
Look up.
Just up there. Listen to us.
Is it?
Shall we tell her where to go?
Shall we?
Does she know which way to look?
Does she know her way into the mountain?
She's a good girl.
Oh, isn't she?
Look up. So clever.
Did you miss us?
Oh, she did. She did.
We're back.
She's so glad we're back. Go
we
on.
Which way to go?
Look up. Go up. Go up.
There's a door.
You can do it.
You can see it.
Come on, Senua.
Go away. I'm not listening.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf, Rayan. But Rayan does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Rayan's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Rayan's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
When you can feel it.
She can feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
No, go in.
Turn
don't.
Back. Turn
back. What's it like?
Get back. A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name. And it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How would you say Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadows?
They can't stop me.
Then do it. Useless here.
Senua.
It's so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate.
It's a trap.
I just want to help them. Tell me what to do.
Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them.
But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and they want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen.
Do you
to
see them?
Do you see their faces? He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now. Does it?
Her torch is going out.
No, it's not. Going out soon.
She hasn't got much time.
Burn out. She's too slow. It's not going to burn out.
The darkness will come again.
We will find you.
She'll have to go under.
She can't.
She has to.
She can't.
I told you, come out.
Don't. Don't come out.
She has to keep going.
She
go
can do it. She can't. Go.
The light's gone out. Run! Get through it as quick as you can. The panic is here.
Reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night, the faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? That there are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
is lighting the torch.
It's not going to help her. She's lighting the
torch. Oh, for fire. Do you think you can keep away from the shadows? If you learn to fight, defend.
Searching for weakness. It found your mother and used her to trap you in here.
Did you see her die? I don't remember. I was only 5. They told me she escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here? Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dillian.
Ah! finish this! Now!
Silence!
Yeah.
give her permadeath. Zimbel was right. Zimbel was trying to save her from the darkness. But she wouldn't listen.
She never chews.
And now everybody is
because of her. It's all her fault.
All her fault.
So weak. She should have known.
Why doesn't she learn? How she learns?
Rian the Dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rian would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rian reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rian go in search of Fafnir.
And he's using it.
Once she gets down there, the lights run out. She'll die.
She has to do it.
She can't.
She'll die.
She has to. She can't.
Faster, faster, keep going, keep going.
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
What's she doing?
She's lighting the torch.
She's making light. She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe.
What's the plan?
Keep going. What is she doing?
Stop! Stop letting the memories in. Stop letting the memories follow you.
Quick!
Stop letting the memories follow you.
Help but think of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Keep the torch alight.
Although Sigurd kills the dragon, Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
I'm coming!
Come back!
leaving with him.
You turn your back on me. That is why Dillian will rot in hell. Come into my shadow.
people think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel. He tried to fix her with his rituals, kept her trapped in that hole. She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness. Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. Maybe Delian would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul. Even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore.
Shadow, listen.
But believe this. It is my mission to make you hate. To hate the darkness with a passion so great it will focus your mind on this quest. Or without it.
Listen.
I fear you would have left those slack. All this time, I wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago.
Follow.
But you have conquered your darkness at every turn. You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
Then take me to the mountain
to trust you.
As deep as we can go.
I won't stand in your way.
She has to trust him. Follow it.
You will not survive what is in there.
Gaze, searching for secrets inside of me. Secrets that even I can't see. I'm not here to fight my past. I'm here for Delian. I will fulfill my vow, whatever the cost.
Destiny of the gods. First, there will be a terrible winter, 3 years long. Then, mankind will turn on itself. Brothers will fight each other to the death, and people will forget what they owe their kindred. Times will be hard. Crimes will be great. It will be an age of axes and swords. The wind will blow through abandoned halls. Wolves will walk where children played. The world will fall into ruin.
Hmm.
again.
No.
She will kill her.
She cannot bargain with Hela.
She's not strong enough to kill Hela.
What is Hela on the table? No one can bargain with Hela.
What is Hela? What can she give her?
If she could give her her own soul.
No.
Her soul's rotting.
She'd rather die.
Oh. It's a worthless soul. But it's all she has to give.
She has a warrior soul. What more could she give? Cursed soul.
Of course she is, no matter what she does.
She can feel the world climbing up her arm.
She can find her. She can find her and Ragnarok.
She's a warrior.
She can see it.
The bridge.
She can't cross the bridge.
It's broken. She has to fix it.
It's too dangerous.
She's done it before. You have to fight on.
We know.
The final battle. This isn't just a broken bridge, is it? Mother, you showed me how to see further. To see the hidden wonders in our world and explore new paths into the unknown. To lead so that others may follow, or to warn so that they may avoid. That is our gift and our duty. I'm not going to look away in fear anymore.